By the authority granted to the Academy by Act of the General Court of the State of Massachusetts Bay in 1780, it is my honor as president to call to order the 1987th stated meeting and induction ceremony of the American Academy. Let me add my warm welcome to the class of 2012 and to the families and friends who have joined us to celebrate them and this special occasion. We're so pleased to have with us fellows from throughout the country, and we extend a special welcome to the foreign honorary members joining us from Argentina, Canada, Denmark, France, Germany, Greece, India, the Netherlands, Switzerland, and the United Kingdom. Welcome also to the representatives of the governments of Germany and the Netherlands joining us today. The Academy benefits from the wise counsel and dedicated leadership of its officers, members of the Academy Council, and members of the Academy Trust. Their names are listed in your program. We are grateful to them for all they do. Thank you all. I would also like to take this opportunity to salute those members of the Academy who have been fellows for 50 years or more. You will find their names on page 10 of your program. The list includes the chair of our board, Louis W. Cabot, who was elected in 1958. Also joining us is past president Leo Baranek, who is marking his 60th year as fellow. Leo. The founding of the Academy in 1780 was a singular act of optimism and hope. Amid turmoil and uncertainty, the Academy was created to help the new nation develop useful and practical knowledge to advance society. Its mission has remained constant with each successive generation, quote, to cultivate every art and science which may tend to advance the interest, honor, dignity, and happiness of a free, independent, and virtuous people, end quote. Academy members, both those being inducted today and the many who have come before, were elected on the basis of intellectual distinction and professional accomplishment. We gather today to honor your diverse and path-breaking contributions, but the Academy is far more than an honorary society. It is dedicated to addressing the issues of the day. As you have heard on a number of occasions already today, we invite you to share your ideas and your time so that the Academy may continue to fulfill its historic mission. This year's class includes innovators in science and technology, the social sciences, the humanities, and the arts. You are cutting-edge researchers and scholars, presidents of colleges and universities, heads of the nation's leading corporations, cultural institutions, and philanthropic foundations. You reflect the diversity and vitality of our nation. You are astronomers who have discovered distant planets and underwater archaeologists who reveal secrets of our past. From microprocesses to macroeconomics, from the origins of language to the original intent of the Constitution, you examine broad concepts and help to develop new technologies. You advance our understanding of the world, and most of all, you give meaning to the human condition. And continuing a 232-year tradition of the Academy, you also help to cultivate every art and science which may tend to advance the interest, honor, dignity, and happiness of a free and independent and virtuous people.